the exercise up to some extent, and in this class we will be continuing with the remaining exercise of the chapter Attitude is Altitude. I think you people are quite excited to learn this. Without wasting time, let's get started. We were going through the questions which were there in the textbook after the chapter. So today we will be starting from the question number 7. Question number 7 says that what made Nick choose Bethany Hamilton as his teacher to learn surfing? The question says that what made Nick choose Bethany Hamilton as his teacher to learn surfing? So, as we have gone through the chapter, we came to know about that Bethany Hamilton was a surfer who has chosen surfing as her passion, and while surfing, once she got trapped by a shark who has bitten one of her hand and she has became disabled permanently. But she did not lose hope, and with double passion and energy, she continued his profession. This made Nick to choose Bethany Hamilton to learn surfing. I hope you have understood this question very well. Let's go to the next question. The next question says that which aspect of Nick's physical condition helps him to do a 360-degree spin? The question says that which aspect of Nick's physical condition helps him to do a 360-degree spin? In order to answer this question, let's get to the few last paragraphs on page number 5 of our textbook, and where Nick says that she was amazing, said Nick. She taught me how to surf, and I was terrified at first, but once I got up there, I felt absolutely fantastic, and I caught some waves pretty well. Nick quickly learned how to do 360 spins to his board, a feat that got him on the cover of Surface magazine within 48 hours. So, from this paragraph, we can understand that the feat that he had, that he calls as chicken drumstick, it helped Nick to do a 360 spin over there. Since Nick was merely a torso. He did not have any limbs to support him except that small feet which was attached to his left hip. So this was only the body part which helped him to do a 360 spin and get him on the cover page of a magazine within 48 hours. That is, he has become quite famous by doing this. Let us see the next question. That is question number 9. The next question says that what are the distinct features? What are the distinct features of this text? List them. So the question says, list out the distinct features of this text. So what does the question mean? The question says that what are the special features of the text or of the chapter? What we have learned. So one of the best feature of the chapter is it is very motivating. In other words, it tells us that even though so many difficulties are there in our life, so many obstacles will come in the path of success, but we need not to worry. We should always be patient and we should always be eager to try new things. At the same time, we should not lose hopes over our shortcomings. We should always try to overcome those things. So this is how this text is very motivational towards us. At the same time, this text tells us to keep always positive attitude towards the life. It explains that even though you have born with some small kind of disabilities, you need not to worry. You should always try to find a path to overcome that. In that way, you can become a mentor to the world and you can set an example in front of the world that everyone can become success unless and until he wishes to. So these are the salient features of the text. Moving to the next question. The question says, it is 10th question, and it says that what do you learn from the life of Nick Vujicic? What do you learn from the life of Nick Vujicic? Since it was a very motivational chapter for us and we have gone through the various aspects of Nick's life, so we can say that we have learned so many things from Lick's life. We have learned that we should never lose hope. We have learned that we should be always trying hard and hard to become successful and trying deleting all the shortcomings. So these are the things that we have learned from Nick's life. Next. The next question says that do you think disability is an obstacle to achieve success? Life. Substantiate your argument citing evidences. From Nick Wozicki. Biographical account, attitude is altitude. So this is the question we have. Do you think disability is an obstacle to achieve success in life? Substantiate your argument citing evidences from Nick Vujicic's biographical account, attitude is altitude. This is a very genuine question, and the Nick Vujicic has actually proved that disability can't be an obstacle in order to achieve success. You just need that fire in yourself. Let us see some of the evidences in the text itself, which shows that disability is not an obstacle, but an virtue in order to become successful. And Nick Vujicic has used it. It says that Nick Vujicic is a multi-talented person. He plays golf. He can play football. He even knows how to surf. He does almost everything on his own without seeking help of others. So this attitude of Nick Vujicic shows that disability cannot stop a man from becoming a successful person. Nick uses his small leg attached to his left hip in order to write and hold things. He can brush his teeth himself. He can do a 360 flip. He does such things that even some well-healthy person with no disability can't do. What do we get from this? We understand that if you have decided something to do, you will definitely do that. And that thing was proven by Nick Vujicic. I hope you have understood the answer to this question. Let's move to the next question. So the next question says that given below are some of the statements made by Nick Vujicic. Which of these are substantiated by Nick's life? So I will read those statements one by one and we will interpret them. So the first statement says that The second statement states that I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. Next statement that he made was, I tell people to keep on getting up and they fall. When they fall, and to always love themselves. The last statement is, if I can encourage just one person then my job is in this life is done. These are the four statements made by Nick Vujicic. Let's read them one by one. I realized why God had made us like this. The next one says, I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. The next thing he says, I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves. Next he says, if I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. You can see these statements and interpret that how highly positive he was. There was no sort of negativity in Nick Vujicic. He has taken his disability as a gift of God. as in this first statement, he says that the God had made us like this. He has realized. What he realized? He has given some special ability. He has been given such a body structure in order to prove himself that he also exists in the world and he can perform all those things as a normal person, and he also can become successful doing all those things without having proper limbs. So that's what the first statement means. The second statement says that I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. What does it mean? If you talk to a disabled person, they quite blame to God that why God has done this to me. If I would have been having one hand or one leg, suppose for example, then I could have done some things that could be performed by the person who has all this. So instead of cursing God, instead of blaming God, he wanted to thank God that he has given this life to him and he has given the chance to him in order to prove himself. That's particular positive attitude Nick Vujicic has. The next statement is, I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves. This quality needs to be occupied by everyone, but sadly not everybody has this. So Nick says that we should love ourselves, because if we are loving ourselves, then only we can show love to others. At the same time, he says that when we are on some task, when we are on a mission, the success and the failure are parts of it. We should never get disappointed. Instead, with double energy, we should get up and we should try to avoid the mistake which made us to fall in the last session of our attempt. In that way, we can achieve success. Not immediately, but definitely. Next, the last statement is, if I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. He thinks that his life is worth being, not being copied at least, but being inspired. If somebody is being inspired with his life, he will think that he is successful in his life. At least someone is being admired to his life. That is the Nick's thinking. I hope you have understood all these statements made by Nick and what kind of attitude he had, you have understood with this. So let us go to the next question. So now we have arrived to a new section of our exercise, that is nothing but vocabulary. Vocabulary, what is vocabulary? Vocabulary is a dictionary. You might be wondering what type of dictionary. Then what is the difference between vocabulary and dictionary? Vocabulary is the dictionary which exists inside our mind. Whatever the word meanings, whatever the synonyms, antonyms, opposites, we know. It is part of our vocabulary. So, while learning a language, it is very important that we should always try to add new words to our vocabulary. It will help us to improve our knowledge about the particular language, and it will also improve our speaking, understanding, and writing skills. So, let us move into that. So in the vocabulary section, the first question we have, it says that look at the list of adjectives given below in the box. Which of them describe Nick Vujicic? Tick them. So let us see what are the adjectives given over there. So first one is positive. Do you think that Nick was a positive person? Yes, he was a positive person. We have gone through the lesson and we came so far to know that Nick was a highly positive person having a futuristic approach. Next says cowardly. Cowardly. Do you know the meaning of the word coward? The coward means a person who doesn't have courage. A weak person is known as a coward person who tries to escape from the difficult situations. Do you think that Nick was a coward person? No, he was not. So Nick was not a coward person. Next adjective says that arrogant. Arrogant means a person who gets the anger very frequently on small things. So definitely Nick was not an arrogant person. He was a very humble and polite person. Next says that negative. Not at all. He was not at all a negative person, because a negative person cannot achieve great success in his life because he takes everything as negative. Let us see the next adjective we have. Courageous. Nick was definitely a courageous person. He has accepted himself as it is. Although he tried to end his life in the early stage, but slowly when he became matured and he realized that the God has gifted him a life for a purpose, so he realized, and with double energy he has rushed into the life. So he was a very courageous person. Sarcastic. Sarcastic. Nick was never a sarcastic person. He never made any people to feel low. He always motivated people to realize their strengths and weaknesses. So he was not a sarcastic person. Optimistic. He was an optimistic person. Next one says that reliable. Nick was a highly reliable person. Next says that quarrelsome. Throughout the whole chapter, we didn't find Nick to argue with anyone or to fight with anyone. So we can say that he was not a quarrelsome person. So, I hope you have understood this class quite well. We will complete this exercise in our next class. Till then, you practice the lesson and read it till you understand the context in this, and continue to practice the exercises. Myself, Amit Upadhyay, will catch you in the next class.